you've been in this business for a minute now, and I just don't recall any scandals that you've been a part of or whatever. If there's anything out there, it's been like on a real small scale. You kind of like keep things low key. You're a private person. And I think that's a good thing, especially in today's time where everybody is just taking off everything and showing everything. It's weird that you know that you can have a person that has been in the game as long as you have and revered and as successful as you are, people still look up to you.
Thank you.
I don't know if you know that. You know, I know.
Yeah, they tell me. Yeah. But you know what it is? It's like, I guess is the way I was raised. My parents never went for some of the things that are out there. You know, I was born and raised in Brooklyn, mm-hmm. in the Brownsville section of Brooklyn, in the projects. So I knew that character quite well. And yeah. I also knew that in order to be successful in that environment, you had to be determined and you had to be focused. And that's what they taught us. And so when I got picked for Good Times, people say to me all the time, you were perfect for the character because you lived her.
Right.
You lived her. And even in my growing up, being a dancer first, you know, I always wore leotards and tights and I wore my clothes tight and all that, but it was nothing revealing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just right. a little so much. And we never, and my parents, you know, they taught us that is not necessarily sexy, you know? And so I never had a desire to overdo any of that. So when I got on Good Times, you saw me, I wore my clothes tight and all that, but you didn't see any vulgarity or anything.
Right.
And I always thank God for that part because that was my first professional job. So I just went and I was blessed to just get the part and I had a wonderful 5 years on Good Times. And, you know, so I just had a very unique, I think my experience was very unique. Right. It was very different.
And you were saying that you just had to go and audition. You never had to do anything.
To get the part or anything.
To get the part.
And none of that came to me. None of it.
I'm glad you spoke on that because I definitely was going to bring that up considering the climate that we're in right now with all of these high profile people being taken down by the Me Too movement and the Time Up movement. There seems to be a lot of that going on, and people have always been familiar with the casting couch. And I know if there was ever a predator out there, you know, and Bernadette Stanis walked into the room, I can just see them going like licking their chops. And
Well, if they did, they kept it to themselves because they didn't right. bother me.
Right, right. You also had the protection of your family. Your family stayed close to you, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. That's one of the keys I've always thought was keeping family close. And the predators, they're afraid of that type of stuff. So either you're going to make it or you're not. If your parents, especially if your people are really close to you,
yeah,
they don't want that smoke.
Well, no, that's good. Then, you know, the parents and family should stay close to entertainers because that those things are there to protect you.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
Yeah. I was very fortunate. Is your birthday December 22nd?
Yes.
Yeah, that's my sister's birthday.
Oh, really?
I never knew because, you know, you can't trust Wikipedia and some of these other
stuff. Well, you don't trust everything they say because they say I have more children than I do.
Is that right?
And you don't have to trust that. I only have two. But I am a Sagicorn.
Sagicorn. I never heard that expression. What is
it? The first time I heard it, Stevie Wonder said it to me. He said, oh, there's my Sagicorn. I went, Sagicorn? He said, yeah, Sagittarius. And I looked it up and it was a cusp. Called right. Cusp person. Yeah.
Right, Sagittarius and Capricorn. I'm going to have to tell my sister that.
Yeah.
She'll probably be defiant. Because she loves saying she's a Capricorn. You know.
Well, we are considered Capricorns, but there are certain things called a cusp. You have a little traits of the other one in there.